I just slept for 29 hours. Just want to throw that out there. 29 hours. I think I have a sleeping condition. Didn't really want to have to make this video, but my camera got stolen in LA and I lost 2 videos. Fuck! By the way, I fucking hate story time YouTubers. I don't want to have to sit here and explain this, but I feel like I have to. You guys have to know this shit. It's really fucked up and I'm really bummed. I feel so bad for you guys, but it's the way she goes.
Lost all the liquor money, boys.
What?
The way she goes.
So a guy from Vancouver named Cam reached out to me and said he really liked my videos, and we talked for a bit, and he told his buddy in LA about the channel, and he really liked the videos as well. So he said, come on out and we can do some shit in LA, make some videos and have a good time. And I was like, yeah, fucking of course, dude. Like, why would I say no to that? That's the perfect fucking opportunity. So I planned a flight for November 20th, ended up going with Cam, and we were just fucking just exploring LA, like having a good time, going out for the first like week and a half. I didn't do anything because we just wanted to enjoy it. Finally, I was like, okay, we gotta make a video because this shit's fucking awesome. It's a perfect place to make videos. It really is, because everybody reacts so much. So we wanted to do interviewing people in Hollywood, like the offensive interviews, but it's like a Hollywood edition kind of. So we went out to go film, and we ended up finding out that there was a parade on Hollywood Boulevard. So we're like, perfect, we'll go film a bunch of shit. We did. So yeah, we filmed that video. So we got back to our place. We were chilling for a few days. This place was getting evicted and we were like fucking putting holes in the wall and shit.
When your neighbor makes a noise complaint for being too loud, fucking God,
and it was just fucking hilarious. But yeah, so we didn't know when we were gonna get evicted, because they say here's your eviction date, but you don't know when you're actually gonna get evicted, because the eviction happens when the sheriffs come in and evict you. So it can be like ages after. So we're like, whatever, if we get evicted, we're fucking out of here. And we were talking to the front desk guys and they were just so fucking chill. Like, we just became friends with everybody. So we're chilling at the place and we're like, fuck, we gotta go eat, we're hungry as fuck. Me and Cam go downstairs and we talk to the front desk guy. And, well, I won't say his name because for security purposes, but it starts with Aaron. Oh shit, that's his name. I'll just cut that out. Oh yeah, I forgot. He's really baked. I make some jokes like, oh, you motherfucking fried tomato looking ass. And we're like, yo, we're looking for a place to eat. Do you have any suggestions? And he's like, oh yeah, Chick-fil-A has awesome food. And we're like, we're fucking down. He's like, yo, get me a coffee as well. I was like, does it look like my net worth is Bitcoin's graph rate? Okay, fuck off. And I say, no, fuck you. And he's like, well, get me a meal. I'm like, no, it's more expensive, you fucking retard. Why would he get you a meal if I'm not gonna get you coffee? You're gay. And he was actually gay. That's the funny part. Fuck. I'm just digging myself into a hole here. We're like, fuck yeah, let's go get some Chick-fil-A. He's like, it's down the road, like 5 minutes. We're like, fuck yeah, okay, we'll catch you later, Aaron. Have a good one. We'll be back and we'll be eating the food that we didn't buy for you. So we go to Chick-fil-A and we get a chicken burger and it was fucking awesome. I had like these sauces I was dipping. I was like, yeah, this is not penis, but it's good because it's not close to that. So after Chick-fil-A, we go to the vape store and I buy a vape as per usual. What else would I be doing in LA? I was like, fuck, dude, I'm on another level. If you ever been high, it's like higher than high if you're with me and I get a vape. Fuck. It's about 8:39 right now. We go back to the apartment. Open the door.
Open the door. I'ma come in, make a bowl of ravioli, walk out, get in a car, drive somewhere else.
We open the door to the lobby. Aaron, he says, yo, what's up, guys? Crazy just happened. You guys got evicted. The sheriffs came, and when they came, the door was wide open. I'm like, what do you fucking mean the door was wide open? Like, wouldn't the sheriffs be here if they're evicting us to stop us from going up? He's like, oh, no, man. They left, bro. But yeah, the sheriffs came. You got evicted. Like, you can't go upstairs. And we're like, what the fuck? Because he knew about the eviction, but he didn't know when, like us. And it was really suspicious because we knew that Aaron knew the place was unlocked because he came up earlier that day and we told him it was unlocked. And he was Instagram living the whole place saying like, oh, fucking white people, haha, we're all laughing. Jokes, funny, funny, funny. Yeah, just shit talking the place. We're laughing. It's all in good fun, right?
I'll be out before Monday because they'll know that the housing people will be here Monday morning.
Monday, baby.
Woo!
They ain't got all this shit. They ain't got none of this shit out here.
And then he goes downstairs. Anyways, that was a little backstory. So Jennifer, my manager, yeah, she's saying, don't let you guys up. You guys can't come up. You guys are evicted, so you can't come up to the place. And we're like, well, we have all of our stuff. What, are we gonna sleep on the fucking ground? We need our fucking stuff, like our clothes and shit. And he's like, no, I don't know, man. My manager, Jennifer, is gonna get so mad. And I was like, dude, I don't give a fuck if your manager's gonna get mad. I'm not gonna fucking sleep outside with none of my luggage. I was like, I have to go up there. I don't know, I'll climb the fucking roof. I don't care, I have to get into the place. And he's like, well, Jennifer's gonna be really fucking mad. Like, I'll let you guys up. She's watching the security camera footage. She's gonna be fucking pissed. I'm like, well, okay, whatever. Let us up. I don't give a fuck. He lets us up. He's like, the doors are locked, okay? Like, the sheriff's locked the doors. We're like, all right, cool. Boom, sixth floor. We go up to the penthouse suite. We go to the door, try and open it. Doesn't open. Okay, well, we can go up the stairs and get through the back door on the roof. So we go up the stairs, go to the back door, it's open. And we're like, whoa, hold on a fucking second. The sheriffs would have made sure it was locked if they actually had come. We're like, what the fuck? Okay, whatever. The front desk people know we're up here, so we're just gonna grab our shit and get the fuck out of here. So we go up, we're like running around, blah, 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 putting all our shit in. There's a knock at the front door. I'm like, okay, fuck. Who is that? Aaron, like, telling us we have to fucking leave. And I'm upstairs and Cam is downstairs. So I'm at the back patio's door and Cam's downstairs near the front door. So he's like, yo, someone knocked. Don't fucking open the door in the back. And then I'm at the top. I'm like, okay, cool. Throw all my shit. And then I hear knock, knock. And then I look to the window and there's a fucking security guard. Not the front desk guy. Security guard's looking at me. He's like, open the fucking door, right? Because probably gonna phone the cops. I'm like, oh, fuck. Okay, walk over. Hey, what's up, man? Like, we have to grab our shit. You understand that, right? Like, I can't just leave this place without my shit and sleep on the ground. I have no money. He's like, yeah, just be quick. Aaron says the manager's talking to him and she's fucking pissed. I was like, oh, fuck. Aaron comes in through the back as well, the top floor. Comes in. He's like, you guys gotta fucking leave. And Aaron's like on his phone, yeah, Jennifer, they're leaving. I know, I'm sorry. They won't leave, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, oh, my God. Like, we just have to, like, tell her we have to get our shit and we have to get our money and everything. And Aaron's like, yeah, Jennifer's mad, man. Like, you guys gotta fucking leave. And the security guard's like, fuck, dude, Aaron's saying Jennifer's mad. Like, you guys do have to fucking leave here. And I look around for my camera. I'm like, oh my God, where is my fucking camera? It's the one thing missing. And I'm looking for it. I'm like, it's not anywhere in sight. So I'm like, yo, Cam, where the fuck's my camera? That's like the most expensive thing in the fucking house. We don't know what to do. I keep scrambling, looking for it. They're like, Jennifer's fucking mad. You guys gotta leave. I'm like, fuck, I need to find my fucking camera. That's the one thing I have to have. I have two videos on it. Like, what the fuck? I can't lose this thing. And so we go downstairs. I'm like trying to find it. And they're like, you guys gotta fucking leave. We have to phone the cops if you don't leave. Aaron's like, the manager's getting so fucking mad. Like, keeps saying she's watching the security camera footage. We're like, hey, fuck, we'll leave. Oh, shit. Hey.
Hi.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Yo, Ryan's here and Neil's here.
Are we filming today?
No, we're not filming.
Shit.
Fuck! You guys are just gonna have to sit down and watch.
Cool.
Okay. Bitch! Now the boys are here. Now I feel like a pussy when I tell. Shut up, Wallace! Now I feel like a pussy when I'm talking. Okay, back on track. So we're like, okay, fuck. Well, I guess we'll go. We haven't looked too hard for all our shit. So I'm like, maybe the camera's here, whatever. I don't think it is. I think someone stole it because I thought I knew exactly where I put it. So we dip out, we go down to the lobby and we're like, okay, can we stay in the lobby while we phone the cops because someone just stole our shit? And the front desk guy, Aaron's like, you guys gotta fucking leave. You can't be doing that. Like, you can do it outside, but you gotta fucking leave. And we're like, what? We can't stay in the lobby? Like, that's fucked up. We're trying to phone the cops because someone stole something from our place. And he's like, no, you guys gotta leave. So we go outside, have all of our shit, like, we both have three bags of luggage. We're sitting outside phoning the non-emergency cops and they're like taking forever. And then Aaron comes outside with the security guard. The security guard listened to Aaron because Aaron said Jennifer's fucking angry at us and she's watching the security camera footage right now. And we're like, fuck, well, we have to fucking phone the cops. How is that not okay to sit outside? He's like, no, you gotta get out of the front. Like, Jennifer's fucking pissed. You guys gotta leave. And I'm like, fuck, okay, whatever. We go down the block and we're phoning the cops still. It takes ages because it's non-emergency police. And then they finally come. The police officer's like, yo, what happened? We're like, yo, my camera got stolen. The sheriff's kicked us out of the apartment. We got evicted, but someone stole my camera. Like, I don't know what happened there. He's like, well, the sheriff's would never take anything, so. And we're like, ask the neighbors, because that's the only people that could have actually gone into the place, either them or someone that worked there, right? Knocks on a few doors, no one says anything, comes back out, he's like, you can file a police report for the camera. I'm like, okay, I guess I'll file a police report. Or before we leave, we say, okay, peace out, Aaron, because we're like, we thought we were on good terms with him, because we thought a neighbor stole the camera, so we're like, yo, peace out, Aaron, security guard, love you guys both, you're fucking dope as fuck, because they're awesome to us. So we leave, we keep Ubering to places, but because it's like 1 a.m. when we're going to these motels and like the Airbnb places, it's like too late to check in. So it was like 4 a.m. and we finally find a motel and they're like, yo, the checkout's at 10. I'm like, oh, well, fuck. I'd rather sleep on the ground. We don't want to pay $150 to sleep for 6 hours. Whatever, we'll just sleep on the ground. I would let somebody pay me $20 an hour to sleep on the fucking ground. I would do that shit. It's not that bad. Well, it was really cold. I thought it'd be warmer, but it was really cold. And we don't have any sleeping bags or anything. So we're in all our fucking clothes. We end up just sleeping in this. It's like a patio type thing for the motel people to come out on. And we just lie down and just pass the fuck out and hope nobody comes. We sleep and it's about 7 a.m. And we get up because Cam's like, yo, dude, someone just walked by and they saw us. And I'm like, okay, well, let's fucking leave. I don't want to get arrested in another country. So we fucking dip. We're like, okay, we need to find a place to sleep tonight because we're evicted still. So we go to this place and they're like, okay, check-in's at 3. I'm like, what the fuck do you mean check-in? Okay, it's 10. I guess we'll wait here for 5 hours. So we wait there for like 3 hours, and then one of our buddies that we met down there is like, yo, there's this motel. The check-in's earlier, you can go there. And we're like, okay, cool. So I ended up going to bed there. It was like 4 p.m. Go to sleep, wake up at 11 a.m. So I sleep for 19 hours because we were like fucking exhausted. Like we were carrying our luggage around. I was so bummed out earlier. And we wake up and we're feeling refreshed. We're like, cool, we're feeling good. So we're like, let's go back to the penthouse and we can phone the cops and we'll talk to the lobby people, see if we can file a report and shit. We go there and at the lobby, we open the door and they're like, yo, what's up? And we're like, wait, were we not evicted? And they're like, no, what do you mean? And we're like, wait, what the fuck? We just slept on the ground and then paid for a motel the next night. What do you mean we're not evicted? Like, no, you're not evicted. I'm like, what the fuck? And we talked to the manager, Jennifer, and we're like, hey, Jennifer, Aaron told us we're evicted and my camera was stolen. She's like, what the fuck? I was never told anything about this. And we're like, well, okay, why were we evicted? And why is my camera stolen? Who the fuck stole it? There's security camera footage, right? And she's like, yeah, there is. I'm like, okay, well, there's no way anybody would steal that shit. Like, they're retarded if they stole my shit. Aaron was baked. So we go up to our place. I look around for my camera. Maybe I misplaced it. Nowhere in sight. I'm like, oh, fuck me. This is really shitty. Ugh. So we come down, phone the non-emergency cops, and they're like, sorry, you guys gotta come to our place and file a police report. And the manager, Jennifer's like, yeah, file a police report. And we're like, what the fuck's that gonna do? Whatever. She's like, just do it. So we walk like 30 minutes to the police station in Hollywood. They actually have it here. We file a police report with them. I don't know if you can read it here. We get this, and the police officer's like, oh, you're not gonna find it. I was like, thanks, you doubtful piece of dog shit, fucking Hollywood up my penis, you fucking dick. And I'm really stubborn, so I'm like, nah, I'm gonna find the fucking camera, eat my asshole, cops. We go back to the place. Hey, Jennifer, here's our fucking police report. She's like, okay, I don't really need it. I'm like, what do you mean you don't need it? You asked us to go get one. And she's like, yeah, that was more for you. I was like, my God, bitch, I just went down and got one. She said she needed one to look through the footage. And then she's like, yeah, it's more for you. I'm like, oh, bitch, I'll kill you with my bare fucking hands. But because I gave her the police report, she knew that I really fucking meant business. I wanted this fucking camera back. And I remember at this point, I'm like, oh shit, I had fucking one video that I actually put onto a drive and there's two videos on the camera. So I'm like, okay, if I don't get this camera back, I lose two full fucking videos in Hollywood. Like, it was golden footage. I'm just like, fuck no. And we had plans for the rest of the trip just to film. So I come back with all this footage and we only have one video. So I'm like, okay, I can't take no as an answer. I need my fucking camera. So she's like, I have all these things to do. I'm like, bitch, I'll fucking kill you. I'll look through this stuff because I know it means a lot to you. I'm like, okay, thanks, bitch. Me and Cam go upstairs. That night we come downstairs and we see Aaron and we're like, yo, Aaron, how's it going, man? Like, what the fuck? The sheriff's never came. We never got evicted. And he's like, I don't know. Ask Jennifer. And we're like, no, you said that to us. He's like, I can't say anything. I'm like, You're fucking retarded. Like, I didn't say that. I was just mad as fuck with the guy. I was like, hey, whatever. Like, you're gonna lose your job if you stole it, so you're bummed. Talked to Jennifer. She's like, yeah, hey, I've looked through it. I still have to look through this stairwell footage. I was like, okay, shut the fuck up, bitch. We go upstairs, go to sleep in our evicted apartment. Thank you, Aaron, for that fucking information, you cunt. Wake up the next morning. Cam comes over to me. He's like, dude, we can't film anything. I'm gonna go back to Vancouver. I booked my flight for tonight. I'm like, no. That means I can't fucking film after. So even if we get my camera back, we can't continue filming. So I'm like, okay, fuck. I guess I'm gonna be here until I find my fucking camera. Go downstairs, talk to Jennifer. I'm still looking to infinite. We didn't see Aaron that day, and usually he worked at night every night. Cam leaves that night. I'm alone, and this penthouse didn't have Wi-Fi because he was getting evicted. So that's why I wasn't Snapchatting and Instagramming and shit like that. Go to sleep again. Wake up to a knock on the door, on the front door. I was like, okay, I can't be fucking bothered. Like, I'm asleep. I'm not waking up. Go back to sleep. Wake up 4 hours later. Go downstairs. I'm like, hey, what's up? I heard a knock on my door. I'm like, yeah, come follow me. I'm like, okay. Go into their little like manager lobby thing, and the guy working there opens the cabinet, pulls out my full fucking camera setup with the mic and the light on it still, and it's like flipped over. And I'm like, okay, only a retarded person would fucking put it on the wrong way. I'm like, Aaron's pretty retarded. No, I was just fucking like, whoa, that's weird. So someone did steal it, obviously. Like, it wasn't just misplaced or anything. Obviously it wasn't misplaced. I fucking put it down and it was stolen. He gives it back. I'm like, whoa, what the fuck happened? Where did you get this? And they had all told me I wasn't gonna get it back. Cam told me I was gonna get it back. Everybody doubted that I was gonna get it back. And I was like, bitch, I'm gonna fucking get it back. The Joe gang needs me. So I get the fucking camera and I'm like, yes, bitch. Yeah, I'm gonna flick that bean around the world. I was ecstatic. I felt fucking amazing. And I opened the SD card slot and I'm like, oh, it's gone. And I had two videos that I filmed on the fucking SD. I was like, no, I lost two fucking videos. So the person that stole it, Aaron, fucking didn't put the SD back because they probably thought it was traceable or something because it's fucking retarded. Here's a video of me saying Aaron's retarded.
Here's the camera that I got back from the front desk guy who stole it. He gave it back backwards because he's retarded. I'm really bummed that the guy stole the camera and I don't have the footage from the two videos, but at least I have one video. Footage. Here, this place is just completely fucked, eh?
I talk to the front desk and shit, and I'm talking to them. I'm like, okay, what happened? Like, so did Aaron steal it? And they're like, no, the maids found it in the stairwell. I'm like, oh, that's weird, because I went up every fucking stairwell looking for the camera. So I'm like, bullshit. Tried to cover their ass by saying, oh yeah, the maid found it, and they didn't want me to sue them, even though I'm not gonna, because like, I have my camera back, whatever. I forgot to throw in, after we came back from the fake eviction thing, the two TVs were missing from the place as well. I was like, oh shit, we told the security guard he could take the two TVs because Aaron told us the place was being evicted, and he also told the security guy. So we're like, oh shit, so the TVs were stolen by him, but they weren't stolen. Come to find out, the security guard messages me about the camera and the TVs. So here are the screenshots. He was a fucking awesome guy. I'm so mad he got fired, but they didn't take away his security badge, which was I was so happy about, because I told Jennifer, hey, the security guard, we told him he could take the TVs because Aaron said the place was being evicted and it wasn't his fault, but he still got fired, but at least he didn't get his security badge taken away. And then the security guard tells me Aaron got his fucking badge taken away, so he's never gonna be able to do a security guard job ever again because his badge is stripped. And I'm like, fuck yeah. And they can't find the guy, apparently he's on the run from them, like he's hiding from them, which is hilarious. But he's fired and he got a security guard badge taken away, so he's fucked for life because he was a fucking idiot. The place where my buddy's penthouse is at is the Avenue, and here's the Avenue's number: 323-876-1619. Come on, guys, don't phone them. Just show them some respect, like they showed me respect. So I'm in a little bit of a predicament here because I only have one video, but it was the funniest video, luckily. But I lost two videos. I know it's been 3 weeks without any videos on the channel. Really sorry about that, guys. But I'm back and I'm better. www.brodytv.com. Merch link is in the description. Thanks everybody for watching. I'm so sorry I haven't posted, but I had to explain this to you guys. I'm in like a story time little, like my penis got erect. Please like and subscribe. The Choke Gang's back and I'm never fucking stopping. Let's fucking get it. Ah.
Who is he stinky? Messy like Binky. Bon appetit. Okay. I don't see nobody better than me. All these pussy niggas are jealous of me. Got a pussy wetter than Swiffer, you see. Still a nigga flow with murderous beat. Stole a nigga bitch, she murdered my meat. Had a nigga numb from feet in the knee.